Recording now. So I'm going to talk about the body elemental. So what is the body elemental and how do we get one? And what are we supposed to do with it? These are the essential questions. Well, the body elemental, another name for it could be the body consciousness. And it comes to us each lifetime, and I hope it's okay if I say each lifetime, because I think that we get the same body elemental that comes down lifetime after lifetime. But it comes in this lifetime at the moment of conception between the egg and the sperm. And at that point, it then encodes us for our DNA. And our DNA that actually works with what kind of sex will you be, how tall will you be, your eye color, your hair color, all this kind of thing, only accounts for 2% of the actual DNA. The rest of the DNA, according to recent scientific findings, used to be called junk DNA because people didn't know what it was good for, and now it's called non-coding DNA. And this other 98% of DNA actually works with your all the other patterns, your emotional patterns, your mental patterns, your spiritual patterns, your epigenetic patterns, all the family wounds, the family history, the ancestral history, all of this is in this other 98%. And so we're going to be working with this 98% when we're talking about the body elemental. So the body elemental, it works with the great beings who are overseeing our evolution. We could call it the Akashic Records if you want. And in this, it's also called the Book of Life, and all of your lives are recorded as a soul. Who have you been, who are you now, and who have you the potential to become? And so we're given a certain package for each life that we need to accomplish. And in this package, which the body elemental gets, it starts to build the physical body. So, for example, not only does it look at the eye color, the hair color, the height, the weight, all this kind of thing, but it also looks at the physical lineage that you're bringing in and what has got to do with that particular physical lineage. For example, I have had my DNA tested now, and I'm 50% Irish and 30% Scandinavian. So obviously, I have a link to this ancestral lineage, and I need to look at how does that impact on my physiology and my life today. It also works with the body elemental, also looks at the emotional body that it is composing for you, constructing for you. So that would be, are you going to be an introvert or an extrovert? Are you going to work more from a place of good relationships with others, wanting to be with others, or is it that you like to learn and grow and have a lot of alone time? Will you have an inclination to be more of a natural child, a nature person? Will you be more of an athletic person where you actually have to do athletic, heavy-duty stuff every day in order to feel well? Or will it be more of a, I have to be around people because it's really people nurture me, not so much nature, but people nurture me. And I want to feel loved and appreciated, and I can't stand being rejected, and these kinds of things. It actually works on our mental lineage. And what some people are good in mathematics, other people are good in computers, some people are good in linguistics, some people are good in art, music. So what are these natural mental qualities that you have that you are bringing in? And it also works with the spiritual body, the lower spiritual body especially. And this is where the past lives come in, that we may feel drawn to other religions, other cultures, because we've had past lives in those. And these are echoes that are coming out for us now. And we could have had past life wounds that we are called on to heal in this life. For example, why would I have got hung at age 19 from a mosquito? Well, this was an echo for me of a past life where I had been hung. And I have always had difficulty with the throat chakra and speaking out and not wanting to speak out or be the focus of attention where I would have to speak. So as a younger person, I always wanted to be hidden and not to be seen so that I wouldn't be outed. No one would discover about me, because to be seen as a child would not be safe. Not for a mystical child anyway. My brother got sent to a psychiatrist to be fixed because he was doing different kinds of things. And he came back changed. So I decided that I better just be quiet and shut up. And this was the best way to be. So, but this is also an ancestral pattern. It isn't just in my family, an Irish family. It is also, Irish people are very secretive. You may think that Irish are known for their bon ami and hail fellow well met and good storytellers and whatever. It's all a cover up. They're actually most secretive about things that they want to keep hidden and secret, because this is the way they protect themselves. This is the way that they protected themselves in history, by flying under the radar, right? So, so they cover it up by this particular facade, if you like. Not that it isn't real, you see, it can be just as real, but it is one part of the personality that gets emphasized when the other part of the personality gets de-emphasized. So that's what we're going to be looking at, are have we got all the parts of our personality flowing and working together rather than having them out of balance, really, for fear. So the body elemental works with all of this. And so in the early part of our life, we receive all this, and then it starts to manifest when the environmental triggers appear. We will have in our coding something that awakens, like a flower awakens. It can be a certain relationship that can cause a certain aspect of us to bloom or to shrivel. It can be the actual physical place where we live that causes us to awaken or shrivel. And this goes on. But then at some time during our life, we become aware that we are not the person who is creating our thoughts. that something else is actually, our thoughts are out of control. They're having their thoughts, but they're out, but we are not wanting to have those thoughts. And we're trying to take control of our thoughts, trying to take control of our emotions, try to change behaviors. And we're saying, good God, how did this ever happen that I seem like I am programmed? And when this occurs to us, that we're on automatic pilot in a way with part of our life, then we start realizing that a lot of what is going on is coming from the unconscious. And this is when we start to consciously work with the body elemental. Because I spoke last night about the conscious part of us is just the tip of the iceberg. And then the unconscious is all of this down here.